Te kaimawhiti tau noi ho ngā pakeke o Mitch Evans. Arā, rānoa tu ona hino ngā nui. I tō whakai huaka ia, i te whakataitai eke waka arā ko te Grand Prix i te tau 2001. Nā reira, he tika, kia whakawhitiwhiti kōrero Tyra. O hiri mea i te waka o Taku Rāmutu, kia pai atamā whakataitai. Me ho ake. Just come back from Europe, Barcelona. What was that like?
Barcelona is an awesome place. The city's amazing, and also the circuit. So last year I had my first GP3 win there. It was a very special moment and a special track to me.
Now I understand you started racing at the age of 6. Is that right? Go karting.
That's correct. Yeah, 6. I got that's when you can legally. So I had a few goes when I was about 4 and 5, but I started racing when I was 6, and I got a my first go-kart on my 6th birthday, so I got straight into it.
What was the thing that made you do it?
My father's father was heavily involved, and my dad was heavily involved, and my older brother is involved in it as well. He got into go-karting when he was 7. He's a few years older than me, and then I got an opportunity as well, and it's just been, you know, the oil's been in my veins ever since.
I understand you have a Māori ancestor, is that right?
That's correct, yeah. I've also got Croatian and Welsh in me, but yeah, I've got some Māori in me, which is fantastic, you know, especially since it's our native culture in New Zealand, and it's great to be part of it.
Would you say go-karting beforehand helped you a lot?
Yeah, go-karting's, you know, perfect breeding ground for jumping into cars because it gives you the basics, you know, racecraft and the feel for the grip and corner speed and also passing other cars. So it's a perfect way to get into, you know, racing cars.
When you were 12, 13, you were competing against 16, 17-year-olds?
Yeah. You know, when I raced in Australia when I was only 14, and there's people in early 20s, late teens, and I've always raced against people that have always been, you know, a good few years older than me, so I've kind of been used to racing against older people.
Did you used to beat them at an early age?
Sometimes, yeah. They don't like that too much. Yeah.
GP3 looks quite easy to a lot of people, but how hard is it?
Physically, it is very demanding on the body because, you know, most corners we get up to about 4.5G, which is G-force, which is 4 times the amount of gravity. And you are strapped in, you've got a 5-point harness, but a lot of strain goes through your neck and you feel those G-forces, you know, throughout the race, especially over, because our race is a half an hour. After getting smashed out for half an hour, you feel it in the end, and that's one of the reasons why we're going to be so fit to race. And, you know, some of the F1 cars are getting up to 6G and their races are nearly 2 hours long.
So what do you do to prepare yourself before racing?
You know, I've got a pretty strict training program every day. I train 6 days a week. I train alongside my manager, who's Red Bull Formula 1 driver, Mark Webber. So it's great to have a benchmark, you know, with him and to train with someone at the top of their game. You know?
Learning from the best, eh?
Exactly, yeah. And, you know, I've realised it's, you know, you've got to be very disciplined and make a lot of sacrifices in life. But in the end, it's going to be worth it, and it's good to be healthy as well.
Now, what goes through your mind when you're going, what, 280 kilometres an hour? It must be crazy.
Yeah, I guess the only thing that goes through my mind is how I can go faster.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
But, you know, when you hop back into a road car, you just got to try and control yourself a bit.
Have you had any crazy accidents while you've been racing?
I've had a couple. Nothing huge, but a few injuries. You know, I think it's just natural when you're trying to push yourself over the limit, and once you go over the limit, you can, you know, hurt yourself a bit.
What's going to happen for you in the future?
You know, it all depends on my results for this year in GP3. I really have to have a great year and try and win the championship. The championship's over 8 races. I have to really do well to try and get the financial backing for next year and try and move up to the likes of GP2 or other classes. So, and just try and move forward towards Formula 1, which is my ultimate goal. But it all depends on results. Proven to people that you're the real deal when you've got the full package. You know, this year I'm out to win. Fair bit of pressure this year, but I'm ready to deliver.
You going for a race?
I am.
Get the tere kokoro. Still us.
Excuse me.
Good one, still there.
Alright,
head start.
Come on.
Holy Hitler, look, there's a Formula One.